Video number four for the complete and utter beginner. In this video, I'm using Virtual DJ. What I'm about to explain, though, is pretty much identical to any DJ software you're using. So I'm really generalizing here. And again, you're going to be using, hopefully, a controller. So in this video, we're looking at setting the beat grid. So let's imagine you have two tracks, identical, same BPM, but they're not at the same position. The beat grid is off. Now, the beat grid, what we can see here is these small lines. And I don't know if you can see, but the top one isn't lined up with the bottom one. Now, again, what I'm about to show you, you will have to do yourself, but I'm just demonstrating here. We're not going to have any audio. It's literally a case of showing you how to set the beat grid. So what I can do is either the top or the bottom, I can move, highlight one of the beat grids. Here we go. And move it backwards or forwards. So I'm going to move that forwards simply because what we have here, don't know if you could see, but we've got a red icon and a blue one. Now, that is telling me that they are positioned at the beginning of a bar. So you do need to make sure they're positioned. Now, again, depending on the tracks you're using will, of course, depend on if the beat grid will align perfectly with the other track. Now, I don't want to digress too much, but that will definitely happen if you're using, say, a track that's been made on a drum machine and a track, let's say, that has been made by a real band, because a drum machine, 99.9% of the time, if it starts at 126 BPM, it will finish at 126 BPM. Whereas a band, because you've got real people, quite often you may have the track start at 120, it goes to 119, 118. So during the course of those two tracks and the beat grids aligned, they may indeed go off. Okay, so I hope that's a help. Practice and enjoy. Thank you.